Today on the BB3D channel, we'll see a way to save money, keep your Bambu Lab AMS happy, and keep the filament inside it dry right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BB3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. So today, we'll take a look at a way to keep humidity at bay in all four bays of your Bambu Lab AMS unit. This video isn't terribly long, but remember, I add chapter markers so you can move around between the sections easily. Chapter markers and closed captioning are just two of the many conveniences we offer here at the BV3D channel. You probably know this already, but in addition to conveniently storing up to four spools of filament and feeding that filament into your Bambu Lab X1 or P1 series printer, it also functions as a filament dry box. A dry box is different from a filament dryer. A filament dryer uses heat and sometimes also airflow to remove moisture from filament, and there are several on the market to choose from. A filament dry box uses desiccant to absorb moisture from the air to keep the filament inside the box dry. A dryer gets the filament dry, a dry box keeps the filament dry. And the AMS does the dry box thing thanks to a pair of desiccant packs installed behind and below the spools. The desiccant that Bambu Lab uses is pretty good and seems to do a great job keeping the humidity in check inside the unit. To me, this is important because where I live, it's often quite humid. So what's the problem with Bambu Lab's desiccant? The problem is that it's not rechargeable. Once it has absorbed all the moisture it can from the air in the AMS, that's it. It's done. No more. It's ceased to be. It's expired and gone to meet its maker. Bereft of life, it rests in peace. It has shuffled off this mortal coil, run down the curtain, and joined the choir invisible. This is an ex-desiccant. Sorry, got carried away. The point is, the desiccant from Bambu Lab is a consumable, single-use product. So when its ability to absorb moisture from the air has run out, you have to run out and get more by ordering it from Bambu Lab. To be fair, they do include a spare set of the stuff with the AMS, but you will eventually need to buy some. In fact, I did that about a year ago, so I would have some on hand when I needed it. I bought a pack of replacement desiccant, which only cost like $4, but then shipping was another $7. So with tax, it was just under $12. You can tell it needs to be replaced when Bambu Studio consistently reports that the humidity in the AMS is high. This is on the device tab on a scale of 1 to 5. 1 is very dry and 5 is very wet. You can also check the desiccant packs visually. New packs are filled with white powder, but as it takes on more moisture, it becomes a squishy yellowish gel. So if single-use desiccant is the problem, what's the solution? Printable containers that you can fill with reusable silica gel beads. Now, I could have printed this kind, designed to fit in the built-in space in the AMS, and I may still do that, but I chose this model instead. It's called the Spill-Proof AMS Desiccant Box by designer Eon Joey, and it's a remix of other AMS desiccant box models. Eon Joey's version consists of 5 containers designed to fit in the front of the AMS. There are versions that hold round hygrometers, rectangular ones, or square ones, or no hygrometer at all. I'm using the round hygrometer one. The hygrometer is a bit hard to see behind the tinted plastic of the AMS, but it's not impossible. But the alternative would be cutting a hole in the front of the AMS and mounting the hygrometer in that, and I don't want to do that. This model is called spill-proof because the backs of the containers slide in from the bottom instead of snapping on or sliding in from the top. So if you grab the tab at the top to pull it out of the AMS, the back isn't going to slide out of place and release all those silica gel beads inside the AMS. Speaking of silica gel beads, the one I used for this are the orange to green indicating kind. I got these on Amazon, and a 1-pound bag was about $7. They're orange when they're dry and green when they're saturated. So later on, when I notice the hygrometer has started to show higher than normal humidity, or Bambu Studio says the AMS is getting toward the wet side of the scale, I can remove these containers and dry out the silica gel beads. According to the product listing, all I have to do is microwave the beads on defrost for a few minutes or oven bake them for a couple of hours. I'll probably microwave them since that's faster. Basically, recharging is just a matter of heating up the beads until they turn orange again. Then I can load them back into the printed containers and put them back in the AMS. Easy peasy. Hey, if you're enjoying this video, a subscribe would really make my day. That lets me know I'm creating content you enjoy and you want to see more like it. Thanks! The containers have a mesh-like grill on the front and the back to keep the silica gel in place while allowing for good airflow. And I noticed the 3MF file I got from MakerWorld used a cool slicer trick to print that grill. The fronts and backs of the containers print flat on the bed, and they're modeled as solid, but they're sliced with high percentage grid infill and zero top and bottom layers. So the printer prints the grid infill on the first layer and carries that all the way up through the solid front and back parts of the containers, resulting in that nice grill. That trick saves modeling time and probably also saves printing time. Pretty cool. Anyway, after you've printed these, removed the supports from the opening for the hygrometer, installed the hygrometer, loaded the containers with silica gel beads, and slid the covers in place, put them in the AMS. You might want to take the opportunity to check on the original Bambu Lab packs and remove them if they're getting squishy. I don't know if they can leak, but it would probably suck if they did. Anyway, with the new printed desiccant containers installed and the filament reloaded, close the lid on the AMS and watch the humidity in the AMS drop. Mission accomplished. Now the environment inside your AMS will stay at a comfortable level for your filament. After discovering that Bambu Lab wasn't kidding when they said their new PET GHF filament needed to be dried before use, this will help me keep it, and any other filament in my AMS, dry. I feel like this will be cheaper in the long run since I can just dry the silica gel out when it's gotten full, instead of buying a new set that I have to throw away once it quits working. If you want to do this, there are links in the description to the model on MakerWorld, as well as links for the orange to green silica gel and hygrometers on Amazon. And if you already use something like this, share your experience in the comments. Do you like it? Hate it? Let the rest of us know. So, that's one way to make sure your filament stays dry while it's living in your AMS. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe consider subscribing so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool while our filament stays dry.